you good news of great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day a Savior, Christ the Lord. We're going to have a service of light as our Lord came into the darkness and brought light. Pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of light, and to be the glory, glorified through all the world. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and prayers. And we can have the tree lights back on again. Joyce, you want to click the... Keep it going. Blessed are you, Lord our God, our eternal Father and David's King. You have made you've made our gladness greater and increased our joy by sending to dwell among us the wonderful Counselor, the Prince of Peace, born of Mary, proclaimed by the shepherds, and acknowledged to the ends of the earth. Your unconquered Son of Righteousness destroys our darkness and establishes us in freedom. All glory in the highest be to you, through Christ, the Son of your favor, in the anointing love of his Spirit, and in his might forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to sing, O Come, All Ye Faithful. Now I can take the opportunity to welcome each of us here tonight, and more especially to the folks who are at the other side of the cameras and of cyberspace and all that lovely stuff. It's Christmas Eve 2021, and here we are with empty churches, hearts filled with love, and have to worship on. Thank you for taking time to worship with us tonight. The bulletin is given to the glory of God, and in loving memory of parents and grandparents, Samuel and Florence Petten, given by Sadie, Nancy, Jeanette, and families, forever in our hearts. We acknowledge, too, our memorials, Christmas memorials, which are printed in our Christmas bulletin, which some of you may already have, I hope, and will be available to those who would like to have them, and that will be recognized at the offertory as well. Now we're thinking a special Christmas, one that seems very dark in our world, as Jesus was born into the darkness. And now we're going to ask Aaron Churchill to sing Christmas Must Be Tonight. And Aaron, I believe at one time, by a person who will remain unnamed, told me at one time Aaron was the littlest angel in St. Luke's Church. You'll know more than I what that means. And it's a song about shepherds and the night Jesus was born. So now we'll have Aaron. Christmas story and in the Old Testament, and the psalm to begin with, and Barbara will
First reading is from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Joyce will lead you in the psalm tonight. We're going to hear Psalm 98.
Reading responsively. On page 836. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things.
With his right hand and his holy arm has he won for himself the victory.
The Lord has made known his victory, his righteousness, as he openly shone in the sight of nations.
He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel, and all the ends of the earth shall have seen the victory of our God.
Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing.
Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song.
With trumpets and the sound of the horn, shout with joy before the King, the Lord.
Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands and those who dwell therein.
Let the rivers clap their hands and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord when he comes to judge the earth.
In righteousness shall he judge the world and the peoples with equity.
And together, Lord God, we see your righteous rule in all your works, and we join our voices with the song of your whole creation in praising you in and through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Dawe is now going to sing Away in a Manger.
Jesus, lay down his sweet.
Gospel according to Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Tonight, we've asked Gavin and his dad to take part, as they have done in other years, as part of a Christmas Eve worship, to bring the story of the Christmas guest. So please now we'll listen to the music and the word of the Christmas guest.
Good day, everybody. My name is Gavin J. Snow. Accompanying me here on guitar is my dad, Ken Snow. And both of us will be performing The Christmas Guest. It happened one day near December's end. Two neighbors called on an old friend, and they found his shop so meager and lean, made gay with thousand bows of green. And Conrad was sitting with a face of shine, when he suddenly stopped as he stitched a twine, and he said, "Old friends, at dawn today, when the cock was crowing the night away, the Lord appeared in a dream to me, and said, 'I'm coming, your guest to be.' So I've been busy with feet astir, strewing my shop with branches of fern, and the table is spread, and the kettle is shined, and over the rafters holly is twined. And I'll wait for my Lord to appear, and listen closely so I will hear his step as he nears my humble place, and I'll open the door and look on his face." So his friends went home, and Conrad left alone, for this was the happiest day he had known. Long since his family had passed away, Conrad spent many a sad Christmas day. But he knew, with the Lord as his Christmas guest, that this Christmas would be the dearest and best. So he listened, with only joy in his heart, and every sound he'd rise a start, and look for the Lord to be at his door, like the vision he had a few hours before. So he ran to the window after hearing a sound, but all he could see on the snow-covered ground was a shabby beggar whose shoes were torn, and all of his clothes were ragged and worn. But Conrad was touched as he went to the door, and he said, "You know your feet must be frozen and sore. I have some shoes in my shop for you, and a coat that will keep you warmer, too." So, with grateful heart, the man went away, But Conrad noticed the time of day and wondered what made the Lord so late and how much longer he'd have to wait. When he heard a knock, he ran to the door, but it was only a stranger once more, a bent old lady with a shawl of black and a bundle of kindling on her back. She asked for only a place to rest, but that place was reserved for Conrad's great guest. But her voice seemed to plead, "Don't send me away. Let me rest for a while on Christmas Day." So Conrad brewed her a steaming cup and told her to sit at the table and sup. But after she left, he was filled with dismay, for he saw that the hours were slipping away. And the Lord hadn't come as he said he would, and Conrad felt sure he had misunderstood. When out of the stillness he heard a cry, "Please help me and tell me, where am I?" So again he opened his friendly door and stood disappointment as twice before. It was only a child who had wandered away and was lost from her family on Christmas Day. Again, Conrad's heart was heavy and sad, but he knew he should make this little girl glad. So he called her in and wiped her tears and quieted all her childish fears. Then he led her home to her family once more. But as he entered his own darkened door, he knew the Lord was not coming today, for the hour of Christmas had passed away. So he went to his room and knelt down to pray. And he said, "Dear Lord, why did you delay? What kept you from coming to call on me? For I wanted so much your face to see." When soft in the silence a voice he heard, "Lift up your head, for I kept my word. 3 times I crossed your floor, and 3 times I came to your lovely door. I was the beggar with the bruised cold feet, and I was the woman you gave something to eat. I was the child on the homeless street. 3 times I knocked, 3 times I came in, and each time I felt the warmth of a friend. Of all the gifts, love is the best, and I was honored to be your Christmas guest."
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Things are kind of different from what we planned, not just we here or you there, but all across our province, our country, and indeed the world. Things are not what we planned. The way for tonight to unfold for us. As you know, our bishop has made a wise decision to suspend the worship until at least level 3 is moved through. But we can worship, and tonight, in such a mad tear, you may say, we came together to bring worship, to acknowledge that in the darkness of today, just like the darkness of way back 2,000 years ago, life came, new life, and that life was a life of God. God had waited so long for his people to realize who he was and to follow, and it just wasn't happening. So God intervened and sent his son. A nasty world, especially in Judea and Israel, Roman occupation, fear all around, not a pleasant place to live. With us today, it's not particularly a pleasant place to live. With all the natural disasters we've experienced recently in our world, on our screens almost every night, it's not pretty. And then COVID, which we thought we were living and dealing with, rears its ugly head again. But that's not what is important. Because Christmas is not about parties and presents. That's not what Christmas, not the story we hear
of God, Son being born in the world. Christmas is exactly this, Christ Jesus being born into this ugly world of his time, and being born always into our world now, in our time. When we finally get that, I believe things will be a lot different. I can't swear that to be true, but I know that it will be different in that we will have no fear. Yeah, we can get concerned, but we know no matter what, God lives in us. God dwells with us. God abides with us. And God gives us whatever we need to step up when we need to. This past couple of years especially, I look around tonight, there's the three amigas again. At least it's warm, this is all good. We came here and we brought worship online, stepping up. And in fact, as we began this tonight, everything went upside down. We thought we knew everything was great, we knew how to do this. Stuff gets in the way. But still, my friends, this Christmas, I pray this will be the one when Christ child will indeed come again. Lord Jesus, come soon into our hearts, so we may go forward in faith, not fear, that we may go into the world bringing his life to others, as is being done, just not enough of it. In our little communities that we live in, God's presence is alive and well. And that is so special in this day and age. Let the light of Christ that is born, came into this darkness on Christmas night, let it just go brighter and brighter. Everywhere you go, every person you see, let them see the light of Christ in you. And may you see the light of Christ in them. My friends, I wasn't going to have a homily if we had not had to upload Gavin and Ken. The time would have gone on and I could have been more silent. But may the Lord bless us all in our next journey, knowing God is with us. God is in front of us, behind us, beside us, and he will give us everything we need. We thank God for sending Jesus and giving him wonderful earthly parents. It's such a privilege for Mary and Joseph to be earthly parents of God's Son. We thank them in their ministry for having reared him up to adulthood so he could face what he had to face in his future. May God bless us. Amen. Now in the time of quiet, hope you have a quiet home right now, I don't know. It's nice and quiet here. It's beautiful and quiet. I'm going to take a moment to just calm our hearts as Wanda will sing silent tonight.
Holy infant, so tender. Thank you.
all his blessings, knowing that he lived in a world just like ours and did not have to, but did it for us. So we thank especially God our Heavenly Father for the gift of Jesus. Thank you also for the gifts that are brought to your church, the ones that are represented on the altar, the ones that are sent electronically, and the ones that will be dropped off. We thank God also for those who have gone ahead of us, all the saints and might who have been gathered home. And we especially recognize the memorials and the Christmas flowers that are in our bulletin. Rest eternal grant unto them, Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Source of light and gladness, accept all we offer in this joyful day. May we grow up in him who unites us and our lives to you, for he is Lord, now and forever. Prayers are in an alternate source again tonight, and the response is, hear our prayer, hear our prayer. Sisters and brothers, rejoicing in the love of God that has taken flesh among us in Christ Jesus, let us confidently bring to the Lord the petitions of our hearts this Christmas night, saying, Lord of love, hear our prayer, hear our prayers. For the believing community throughout the world, especially those in positions of leadership, praying for our Bishop Sam and Archdeacon Charlie and all our leaders, that they might always work to give glory to God and to bring peace to our earth. Lord of love, hear our prayer. For the church, gathered in our communities, that we might always bear the good news of God's living presence in our world, towards deepening of Christmas faith and living that faith in love. Lord of love, hear our prayer. For those lost in the darkness of prejudice, hostility, and fear, for those burdened by the yoke of injustice, terrorism, hunger, and war, and those suffering from illnesses and COVID, for all our brothers and sisters in any need, especially those who bring in your hearts this night, that the light and life that is the Lord might touch their hearts this night. Lord of love, hear our prayer. For the homeless, for children born in the midst of poverty and pain, that there be room at the inn for all God's people. Lord of love, hear our prayer. For those who are sick, the ones in our hearts, the ones we know of, and those that you know, Lord. For those who care for them, that the God whose love extends from the wood of the manger to the wood of the cross might bless them all this night with the gift of healing and peace. Lord of love, hear our prayer. for those who have died. And tonight we remember Effie Penton, George Morgan, Scott Dawe, Mildred Tucker, and Miles Ronald. And in the year's mind, we recall Molly Boone and Nancy Christopher. May their families be blessed with your comfort and your peace. Lord of love, hear our prayer. I'd ask you to have a moment in your hearts to remember any situations, people that you wish God and God's Son to bless this night. Hear the prayers of our hearts, Lord. Lord of love, hear our prayer. All loving and gracious God, we thank you for gracing us with the gift of your Son. Confident of your continuing love for us, we have placed our needs before you. Hear and answer our prayers through the same Christ, newly born this night, our Lord and Savior, forever and ever. Amen. And in a moment of quiet, I just ask you to recall those places that we have not done what God has wanted us to do. We have ignored people God has put in our paths, and we are sorry for. May the Lord grant us forgiveness and promise us newness of life. Christmas. Eternal God, this holy night is radiant with the brilliance of your one true light. As we have known the revelation of that light on earth, bring us to see the splendor of your heavenly glory through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And our closing hymn on this precious Christmas Eve is Joy to the World. It's number 154 in your hymn books, Joy to the World.
Thank you.
all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and in his Son, Christ Jesus our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen. And perhaps instead of go in peace to love and serve the Lord, because, you know, it's just us, to say Merry Christmas, everybody. And may you have a wonderful Christmas season, as good as it gets, enjoy every moment, and may next year be one that is filled with extraordinary blessings. So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Okay, yes. Go in peace.
Well, this is take two. Anyway, this is Christmas Eve, and it's not what we expected. We expected to have at least 100 people here in St. Luke's Church, and this is Reverend Linda's last service. And so we're going to have Aris to come up and present Reverend Linda with a gift on behalf of the parish. And Reverend Linda, it's been a wonderful 3.5 years with you, and I'm certainly going to miss you. All phone calls and texts and everything, and we just want to say thank you. So Aris is going to come now and present the gift.
Reverend Linda, on behalf of the parish of Holy Grace, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having
me.
Well, thank you. Okay. All right. So, oh my gosh. Okay. All right. Wow. You want to help with this? I got really sorry. Okay. Oh wow. Beautiful.
You'll always have a little bit of Portigrave with you.
How did you know that was my favorite one of all your pictures? I was deliberating the other day with this one, and I'd like this one.
There you go.
Thank you.
I know you're Portigrave.
My husband liked to come up and, no, he doesn't want to come up and sit. Oh, you're okay. That is so beautiful. I'm sure we'll be able to do something later on.
Yes.
COVID. Yeah. Because the bishop is hoping to come out as well.
That's right.
And we would do a little service of, you know, and the agreement being signed. And we've had a ride, I must say. We certainly have with the folks. And it's, thank you. I can't say anymore. Turn it off.